seemingly everybody in the world came forward. Literally, I think the estimate is 300 to 500 people came right towards us.
They were going to kill us. They were going to come in there. They were going to burn down the house. They were going to be living in our house after I was dead. And they were going to, they pointed to different rooms and said, that's going to be my bedroom and that's going to be the living room. And I'm going to be taking a shower in that room. And then the dog barked. I mean, they there were so many threats. And then the dog barked and they said, and I'm going to be killing her too.
Patricia and Mark McCluskey, the St. Louis couple forced to protect their home from protesters, now unarmed. Police went into their home and took their rifle and the pistol reportedly already handed over to their former attorney. But the couple was not arrested or charged. So what the heck is going on here? Joining me now with that by phone, former Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi. So Pam, this crackpot DA out in St. Louis, she's running in a primary for re-election. She's a total joke. And I guess she got a judge to sign off on a warrant to send police in there to take this guy's rifle away from him. It's a very unclear for what reason. This is like the red flag law without the red flag. How is this legal in this country?
It is not legal, Jesse. I've been a prosecutor, as you know, my whole career, and then attorney general. This is an extreme abuse of power by this prosecutor. And this is a glimpse of what a Biden administration would look like. They want to take away our guns. That couple that you're showing on TV, they were defending their lives and they were defending their property, which in Missouri, under the Castle Doctrine, they had every right to do. These people weren't peaceful protesters. They crashed through their gated community armed, came up. They told this couple they were going to kill them, shoot them. They were even pointing out what bedrooms they were going to live in this couple's home. They were going to kill the couple's dog. Look at them on this footage. It is outrageous.
Yeah.
These are good American citizens, Jesse. Look what they did. I'm proud of them.
Yeah, I mean, you're right about the law. There's the Castle Doctrine where you can defend your home. They have open carry in that neighborhood.
That's right.
They have stand your ground there. These were legally purchased weapons. They have the right under the Second Amendment to have these weapons to protect their property and to protect their life. What it looks like to me is this ridiculous district attorney whose conviction rate's just dropping like a rock. She's not getting anything done. She's actually just let looters and rioters off the hook, no charges at all. There she is right there. Her name's Kimberly Gardner. She's funded by George Soros. And this just looks like a political play to me to win votes. But I wish I knew more about this. It's just clearly unconstitutional. I'm outraged by it. I mean, this is the United States of America. You have the right to bear arms.
Jesse, every American should be outraged by this. Every single American. This is our most fundamental right. And not only that, they are protecting themselves. These people are protecting themselves outside their own home on their own property.
Right.
This isn't even close to being legal. He had no legal basis to go in and seize their firearm. What about the people who came in there armed? The couple said those people were armed. They are the ones who should be under investigation. Let me tell you, we dealt with a Soros-funded attorney, a district attorney called state attorney in Florida, in Orlando, and she's now no longer running for office. She wasn't prosecuting cases the way she should have, but that's what's happening. George Soros around this country is funding.
Yeah, they're putting everyone in danger, and they're just shredding the Bill of Rights. I mean, this is what the country was founded upon, some of these rights. And the government can't do that. It's just not right. All right, Pam, thank you.